Restoring an image using EaseUS Todo. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. So far in this series, we've created a backup image and we've created an emergency disk. Now, we're going to use that emergency disk to actually restore the image we took. Now, I want to be very clear about this. It's very important to understand exactly what an image restore means. It means that everything currently on your hard disk will be erased and replaced with the contents of that image. Now, if you've got a replacement hard drive, which is a common scenario, right? Your hard drive fails, you replace it and you restore the most recent image. That's not really that much of an issue. That's kind of what you want. However, if you're doing this because of some other reason, for example, malware, do understand that everything currently on the hard disk will be erased. Okay, with that out of the way, let's move on to actually doing the restore. Step one for the restore is to boot from that emergency disk. Now, unfortunately, I can't tell you how you need to do that, because exactly how you boot your machine from your emergency, be it a CD or DVD or a USB stick or something else, varies from machine to machine. But that's the first step. And here's what it looks like on my machine. All I'm going to do right now is reboot. I have inserted the rescue disk, the emergency disk. We press any key to boot from that CD or DVD in my case. And sure enough, what shows up is EaseUS Todo Backup. That program is on the emergency disk and it gets run automatically when you boot from the emergency disk. There we are in EaseUS Todo Backup. Now, of course, it's suggesting we start our first backup, but we already have one. So what we'll click on here is the Browse to Recover link in the upper right. We're looking on a local drive. We're opening up Computer. I have it on my faux USB drive in My Backups, Disk Zero. This Disk Zero, etc. .pdb. .pdb files are EaseUS Todo Backup image files. So I'll click on that, click on OK. This lists all of the partitions in that image, and we're going to go ahead and restore all of them. This allows us to select where the backup image is going to be restored to. And what's interesting here is that it does take a moment if you have multiple disks on your machine. In my case, I do. If we take a look at this very first disk, it's got G, it's got some other things, it's got my F drive, it's got some other things, got unallocated space. That's not my system drive. That's not the drive I want to restore to. So I'm going to minimize that. Same thing with this hard disk one. Hard disk one is actually my faux USB. That's not where I want to restore to either. It's not until we find the disk that has the C drive. The C drive is the system drive. This then represents the hard disk that is the system drive. It represents the hard disk that we backed up. And it is the hard disk to which we are going to restore. So I'll check that box. We'll click on Next. This is a reminder that what I said at the beginning is very true. We're about to overwrite everything on the existing hard drive. When you're restoring an image, that is what you want to do, but make sure that that's what you want to do. Click on Yes. What we're seeing here is an image of what's going to happen. The source disk layout, this is the copy of the image that we are restoring. And this tells us exactly what the target disk will look like after that restore is done. And you can see they're the same thing because we are basically restoring the entire source disk to the entire target disk. And we'll click on Proceed. And the option gets underway. And we're done. The system hard drive has been restored from its backup image. We'll click on Finish. And now, all we really need to do is reboot our machine once again. This time, simply closing EaseUS Todo will make that happen. But when the machine reboots, don't reboot from the emergency disk. In other words, when it asks you to press any key, in my case, I'm not going to press any key, so that it boots from the hard disk. That then will allow the restored system to be booted from. And we're back. Basically, what we're looking at is the machine exactly as it was at the time I took that original backup image. So hopefully that helps you understand exactly what you end up doing with your backup image. Now, there are other things you can do that are less destructive. This is an all or nothing operation. Like I've said a couple of times now, you're replacing the entire contents of your hard disk with whatever is in that backup image. In the next step, we are going to look at extracting individual files from the backup image without needing to erase anything. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/29825. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.